Welcome to the next session, Exception Handling. In this session, we are going to see how to handle exception in Blue Prism business processes and objects. When we deal with exception handling, the two major components in Blue Prism is recover and resume. Instead of failing in the event of exception, business processes and objects can be designed to handle the exception and try to keep going. Not all the error need to be retired, but based on the business application responses, sometimes need to be. Recover and resume stages are used to attempt to salvage and move from an exception stage. It can be added to the specific part of the flow or even to the whole page. If there is some particular part of exception need to be ignored or retry, use block stage and then link recover and resume. A recover stage acts like a magnet. Exceptions are drawn to it and the diagram flow will jump directly from exception point to recover stage. When Blue Prism is on the path between recover and resume, it is used to be in the recover mode. So often we call it as a recover mode. A resume stage neutralizes the exception, but it does not fix any exceptions. Once passing the resume stage, the exception will be effectively gone and the diagram can continue normally as expected. So coming up next, I'm going to show with Blue Prism how to do the same which we have discussed in the theoretical part in a simple example. I've just created one simple object, exception handling in the name. You can use the same concept in process as well, because we are just going to see how to handle exception with recover and resume. Because recover and resume stages will be available in both Process Studio and Object Studio. So for training purpose, you can use it or you can apply the same logic what I'm going to do with the object with the process as well. It's not going to show any difference. To validate that or to check the exception handling, try to have a simple example. I'm going to use a data item called X and the type data type will be a number and giving the initial value as 1. So use one more data item which is named as Y. You can name whatever you want. So the data item type, it's going to be number again and I'm going to give it as a 0. So now these are the two inputs which we are going to do with the simple calculation. So I'm going to take a calculation stage. So just rename it whatever you want. And as soon as you rename, you have to use the expression into it. So I'm going to use X divided by Y and store it in the result. So we haven't created any data item called a result, but I can create it in this way also. Just write the store in result text, what name you want to store in, and then click the store in icon, which is going to create exact store in data item in the name as expected. You have the result as well here. Just connect the flow and give a reset once before you run. Now it's going to simply do a division from X and Y. So let's start running. Now Blue Prism throws an error, failed to evaluate an expression X divided by Y because it's not going to give any result. It's resulting in infinite. So in this case, the exception or the error thrown from Blue Prism is type internal and you will have a proper exception detail which has been thrown directly from Blue Prism. So in case if you want to ignore this error or if you don't want to consider this error, you can use recover stage and resume stage as I explained in the theoretical session. Recover is going to act as a magnet and it's going to take the exception. When it comes out of resume, it's going to kill all the exception which has happened in this particular section and it's going to continue with the normal flow. So now if I run this section again, this error from this session has been captured by recover and it's going to resume to the normal flow. So whatever exception happened here before we have a resume, Now it is completely taken care from recover and it ended in the resume with a normal flow. In this way, this is a simple example. You can use it in your process wherever you need. In case if you are suspecting some places where you can expect some error, but if you want to have a normal flow, even if there is an error occurred, you can use recover and resume. As I explained in the theoretical session, your recover and resume is not going to resolve the issue, but it's going to stop you, or it's not going to stop your process because of this issue if you had. So in case if you want to have, or if you want to tackle only particular session or particular portion in your business objects or process to handle with it, you can use a block stage. So whatever exception happened particularly at that action, it's going to take care of that. If you have the same calculation stage outside the block, it's not going to take care of that exception, even if it is happening in the same page. So I'm going to give it outside block just for our differentiation. If I run this process, so I'm going to run this. It's going to go for the first one and there is an error and it's going to resume trying to come to the next flow, but still it has an exception. As why the exception from the second one is not handled is like it is not within the block. If you add both of the exception within the block, it's going to get captured from the recover and it's going to continue with the resume. So basically, if you want to have a proper exception handling for particular section alone, not the whole page, in that case you can use block for the particular error expected place or action and link to that with the recover. Or if you want to have a whole recover resume stage within this page, so whatever exception happened in this page, either in an object or process, you can use this as a whole page without any block. So whatever exception happened anywhere in this page, that's going to go to recover and resume and then connect to the next stage, whatever we want as the business flow. So that's on the high level how to handle exception using a block stage to segregate a particular portion, or if you want to put it for the whole page, it's going to handle as like in the whole page. So that's on the exception handling part. Coming next, we are going to see how to throw an exception. Here it is an internal exception. So next stage, we can customize the exception before Blue Prism throw. So we can see more in detail about exception customization and exception types.